girl Rini.
Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to a brand new video. So it is that time of year. We are coming to the end of January and next month is February, and that means Valentine's Day. So today I'm going to be doing a Valentine's Day setup. I know you're looking around and you're seeing all this pink. You're like, girl, you just did a setup with pink. It's like, I know, but I feel like doing it again. Like, and what? But yes, I am doing another setup with pink. I was looking through different color palettes and I was thinking to myself, do I want to do red? And I just wasn't feeling red this year, so I decided to go all pink. So I have three different shades of pink today for you guys. I hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe. So I'm going to be using my stand today. One thing I realized is I am based in Canada, so if you are in the States, you can look it up, see what it's called, and search for it on the American website. Guys, please, please, please don't come for me. I had started doing my hair and I couldn't finish, so I threw on this hat in order to do this video. This is for you guys, okay? Don't come for me. It comes with sandbags. It doesn't come with sand. It just comes with sandbags. I filled mine up with rocks because that's what I had on hand. But yeah, it does come with sandbags. I just don't have them. They're outside in the shed, and I'm not going out there to get them. So, I'm just gonna have to make it do what it do. Okay, so as you can see, once again, I'm using my and we're gonna do. I'm gonna border it with the balloons, but I'm gonna give it more like of an organic vibe. It's not gonna be so clean. It's not gonna be like straight lines. I am going to give it more of an organic vibe. You see what I'm talking about. So let's get started. Now, I could tie my legs together and create these. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. Watch my other videos so you can guess what sizes I'm using already. I don't know why, I just always use those sizes. If I'm doing a big setup, the bigger the setup to me, the bigger the balloons. So I'm gonna use 24s and 36s. When I'm doing small setups, I'm okay with the 18. So for colors, let me look at the top. I'm sorry, the colors. I know I have fuchsia, and I know I have light pink. I have metallic light pink, I think. I'll tell you exactly what it is. One second. It's thick. No, that will work. It'll work. It'll work. Okay. So, what I'm gonna do is attach it to the pole by simply taking two balloons, squishing the pole in between, and twisting the balloon around the pole. I'll show you. Okay, so here's the pole. Here are my two balloons. I'm gonna slide it in. All right, and don't just leave it here. To secure it, I'm gonna twist the balloons. So so that it's secure and it doesn't move. Okay. I'm gonna do that again in the middle. Can you see? Yeah. So two balloons here. Slide it. Let it hug nice and snug. And then twist. One time does do it, but you can do it twice. I'm gonna do that same thing at the bottom. There, because this is very pressure on that. A lot of pressure on that. And that's it. Okay, so we got one side, and now we're gonna make another side, and then we're gonna make one for the top. I do have those annoying triangle bases that I like covering. So I'll just go around filling in some of these to make sure it's not showing, because I don't like it when it shows. Let's see what this is looking like. Okay. Let me see how it looks on camera. Okay. Cool, oh, that's looking all cute and pink and all that. A picture in mind of what I'm going for. I just hope that I'm actually able to bring the vision to life. Shape as opposed to being like really straight and skinny. I'm gonna do something really like random. I'm gonna take this smaller custard, put it at that corner because it looks really short between round. see how it gives it a little more of an edge, a little more of a corner. Just use a smaller crisp. Keep putting more than over there. Okay, so in order to further help me get that organic look that I'm going for, I'm gonna go ahead and inflate some foils. I have some foil hearts, and I have some starburst that I'm gonna add, and I'm gonna add my fillers. Hopefully this thing looks good. I got a few random foils from different brands. So this is gonna be a starburst. Oh, it's a so all in one. Okay. I don't know. Hearts. A few hearts. Different color hearts. All pink. This one is anagram. I don't know if it's gonna come the exact color. I can look on my invoice. My receipt, and I'll tell you exactly what color that is. I have no idea what that is. At least this one from the package is Qualitex. This one is anagram. These are small 9-inch hearts. So these hearts are 18 inches. I got a few 9 inches. Different shades, just whatever I could find online. Some more anagram starbursts. These are in the color, I believe this is rose gold. Yeah, rose gold. I don't know if this is the one where it's all in one. This is like it's a little all in one. You know, you have the starburst that you tie up. Is it even called a starburst? This is called a magic star. I know the starburst, you tie, you blow them up individually and you tie them together. You wrap them together. Let me see. Yeah, so I guess they're different. I just learned something new. I was getting started. Yeah, so this is like the all-in-one. It's less work for me. And then again, what's that? She's a lot thinner than a Qualitex. That's why it's Qualitex. These 9 inches are heat seal. I might not use this. I don't have time for this. I don't have time for heat seals. Hold on. They look like heat seals. Let me see. Boom. No heat seal necessary. No heat necessary. I don't have the actual heat seal. I use a flat iron. It works just fine. But what's time for that? No time for that. I don't know if this will last. I've never done this before. I can't tell when the last time it is that I used heat sealing balloons. I love the self-sealing one. I didn't even see that. Twisting it nice and tight. I don't know how long it lasts. So we'll try doing this for a setup, and then I want to manipulate it and then run to me and say, it's your fault, honey. And until you do that, we're just trying to take it. Tape your elastic band to the back of your foil. Making sure that you're able to get the elastic band like this. I would suggest using the H method to make it super secure. I'm not going to do as I say, not as I do. And that's how you're going to attach the foils, and then you tape it back. So that's that. So that's how I'm going to attach the foils. To the cube, I use it on something else, but we are repurposing it. Do that trick where you wrap it. I think it's hard to valve, but I think that's not a smart idea. For the smaller ones, for the 9 inches, I'm going to use blue dots because they're smaller, lighter, and I'll put 2. Extra secure. that's it. I'm finished. I've completed my beautiful cute pink Valentine's Day garland. I wish I turned this around. I could see the barcode. That's irking me. So just be careful when you're applying your foils. Make sure that you're facing it so that the barcode or whatever logo is on that bottom piece is not showing. Clearly wasn't paying attention. So this video has come to an end. This is my beautiful Valentine's Day garland. I guess you can say it's an arch. I tried to give it that organic feeling where it didn't have a very structured shape. It still came out very like neat in a way. But the foil definitely, the foils, the hearts and the starburst. I wish I had one more, at least one more starburst. But the hearts and the starburst really added to the garland and giving it more of like an organic, fun, I hope you like it as much as I do. Super cute. Spilled the pink. I don't know what's going on with me. Pink. I think pink might be my favorite color. I just don't want to admit it. Like, I like pink. I like some pink. I love me a pink color look. So after that clip, I noticed that a piece of the stand was sticking out, so I went ahead and added a few more balloons just to cover that up. Again, this is the end. This is the complete look. I'm really, really loving this pink, guys. I don't know what it is with me and this pink, but right now we go to get there real bad, okay? But seriously, guys, thank you so much for the support. I am overwhelmed. We are almost at 100 subscribers. I know that might seem like that might not seem like much to some, but honey, I am super thrilled. So please continue liking and commenting on my videos. Please subscribe to the channel. Please don't be a stranger, you know, ask your questions, request, you know, what you would like to see, and I will try to pump those out for you guys. Thank you so much for watching again, and I will see you in the next one.